Hey everyone, this is Vignesh from Easy Way to Learn Medicine. So today we are going to see the Croak 1 anatomy questions explanation. So today video we are going to see surface anatomy and the skeletal and muscular system. So the first question, a patient complains of a pain in the upper umbilical region. On palpation there is a mobile painful induction. What induction being palpated by the doctor? They gave you the upper umbilical region. What is present in the upper umbilical region? So you can see from the image. So the abdominal segment, the abdomen are divided into 9 segments: epigastric region, right and left hypochondric region, umbilical region, right and left lumbar region, right and left iliac region, hypogastric region. In the umbilical region, there is a presence of duodenum, small intestine, and transverse colon. Upper umbilical region, middle umbilical region, lower umbilical region. In the upper umbilical region, there is a transverse colon. In the middle, we have a duodenum. Small intestine, in the lower we have duodenum. So the answer will be transverse colon. Transverse colon present in the upper umbilical region. A patient complains of acute pain in the upper, in the right lumbar region. During examination, the nephrolithic obturation obstruction of a right ureter in the region between its abdominal and pelvic segment has been detected. What boundary exists between these two segments? So these questions, like their repeated question, in which area the ureter, the stone, the kidney stone is obstructed, in the which area, the boundary between the abdomen and the pelvic segment. This segment we call it as the line separating, we call it as linea terminalis. Linea terminalis above, which is abdominal segment, below, which is a pelvic segment. The line which separated the abdomen and pelvic. So the option will, the answer will be linea terminalis, or innominate lines divided abdomen and pelvic cavity into abdomen and pelvic segments. So we can go through the other options why which is not the correct answer, correct answers. So you can check, you can pause the video and you can check it. The third question, a patient complains of pain in a right lateral region. Palpation revealed a dense immobile tumor like formation. The tumor is likely to be found in a following part of digestive tube. Right lateral region, we call it as right lumbar region. Right lumbar region, there is a presence of descending colon, small intestine, right lumbar region, there is a presence of ascending colon, small intestine, and right kidney. So you can see from the image. So the option will be ascending colon. See the right lumbar region, you can see ascending colon, small intestine, right kidney. They gave you right lateral abdomen, right lateral, which is right lumbar region, the presence of ascending colon. The fourth question, during examination of a patient, a doctor should use anatomical division of our anterior abdominal wall. It is divided into how many segments we have in abdominal wall. There is a 9 segment, 9 regions by two horizontal, two vertical. Two horizontal, transpyloric and transtubular lines. Two vertical, right and left lateral line. Two horizontal line, two lateral lines, which divided into 9 segments, 9 regions. In obstetrician, gynecologists measure the pelvic cells of a pregnant woman. A caliper was used to measure the distance between two iliac crests. What measurement of a large pelvic was made? So between the two iliac crests, we call it as distantia crestarum. Distance between two iliac crests. The name of the measurement, the length between the two iliac crests, we call it as distantia crestarum. So you can go through other options. So this is important for obstetrics examination during pregnancy. Examination of a patient revealed hypertrophy and inflammation of a lymphoid tissue, edema of a mucous membrane between palatine arcs, acute tonsillitis. So there is an inflammation of a tonsil, the tonsil which is present in the palatine arcs. What tonsil is present in this area? So you can check in the image, the palatine arc, pharyngopalatine arc. There is a presence of palatine tonsil. So in the area of palatine arc, there is a palatine tonsil is present. A woman with a dense area in her mammary gland come to a surgeon to minimize the trauma to the mammary gland lobe. During the operation, a surgeon should make the incision. So mammary gland situated in the upper axillary lesion. So for to make a mammary gland surgery, it has to make a radical incision, like a C's shape incision radically. So this incision name is called radical incision. So we are moving into skeletal and muscular system. The parenchyma of a patient's little finger complicated by a phlegmon of a hand and foramen. In this case, the suppuration had spread through. This is an inflammation to the nail of the little finger, which is spread to the hand and foramen by the synovial membrane called vagina synovialis communis musculus flexorum. So only this vagina synovialis communis musculus flexorum only joined to the little finger. So if you have any inflammation or any infection in the little finger, it can spread to hand and by the pathway called vagina synovialis communis musculus flexorum. So which is a common synovial sheath of a flexor muscle of a fourth finger extended from four fingers extended from little finger to hand and forearm. A patient is diagnosed with a compression fracture of lumbar vertebrae. A patient presented with acute increased lumbar lordosis. What ligament was damaged in the patient resulting in such a deformation of a vertical column curvature? So for lumbar lordosis, especially the anterior longitudinal ligament will be damaged. So we have two main ligament, anterior longitudinal ligament, posterior longitudinal ligament. Anterior longitudinal ligament damaged by the hyper extension of a lumbar vertebrae. So what vertebrae will be damaged? Anterior longitudinal ligament running down the anterior surface of the spine prevents abdominal inward bending of a spine, called as lordosis. So anterior longitudinal ligament will be damaged. A patient has been delivered into a surgical ward with an incised wound of the anterior surface of the shoulder in its lower one-third. Flexion muscle was disturbed in the shoulder and elbow joint, which is caused by damage the so anterior surface of the shoulder, lower third. It has an incised wound. So what muscle is damaged? So in this region, only muscle we have which is biceps muscle of the arm, so which is used for flexion and supination of the elbow joint, abduction and flexion of the shoulder joint. Fourth question: a soldier with explosion caused trauma was delivered to the hospital. Examination revealed his tympanic membrane to be intact, means like normal position, normal shape. What defense reflex prevented the tympanic membrane from rupture? So there is a explosion. So in the examination, the tympanic membrane, which is in a normal position or a normal shape, what reflex it prevents the tympanic membrane from rupture? So we call it as contraction of musculus tensor tympani. So when contracted, malleolus is pulled medially, tensing the tympanic membrane prevents from sudden loud sound. So it's from rupturing. So for contraction of musculus tensor tympani, so like it is a normal reflex of this muscle, musculus tensor tympani. A comminute fracture of infraclinoid tubercle caused by shoulder joint injury has been detected during X-ray examination of a patient. What muscle tendon attached to this site has been damaged? Infraclinoid, yeah, like shoulder, in the shoulder joint. So there is an attachment of a long head of a trapezius brachii, musculus trapezius brachii, which is originated from infraclinoid tubercle of a scapula. It's from a scapula and inserted into the olecranon process of ulna. So there is a fracture of infraclinoid tubercle. So from the infraclinoid tubercle, there is a origin of muscle called long head of a musculus trapezius brachii. So there is a fracture, there is a damage to the trapezius brachii muscle. A 42-year-old male with lesions of ulnar nerve is unable to flex second and fifth finger. What muscle function is impaired in this case? So, ulnar nerve damage. So, we have to know ulnar nerve innervation, which muscle ulnar nerve is innervated. And we have to know the muscle function. So, ulnar nerve innervated hypothenar muscles. We have like 9 group of muscles. So, especially for flexion of a second, fourth and fifth finger, the muscle name called palmar interossus muscle. The palmar interossus muscle is innervated by ulnar nerve, which helps flexion of second, fourth and fifth finger and attraction towards midline. The female patient has the facial neuritis that has caused mimetic paralysis and hearing impairment. Hearing impairment results from paralysis of the following muscle. So, facial neuritis, inflammation of the facial nerve, and the patient has mimic muscle paralysis. The mimic muscle is not functioning properly and she has a hearing impairment. So, the facial nerve, which supplies the facial muscles, and also it supplies a muscle which is present in a ear, which helps for hearing, called stapedius muscle. So when we have facial nerve damage, it also like defect the facial nerve, facial muscle functions, also the muscle which present in the ear, stapedius muscle. The eighth question. A 19-year victim has been delivered to a casualty department with a cut wound in a trapezius muscle. Which of the cervical fascia forms a sheath of this muscle? So you can see the fascia, cervical fascia. There is a trapezius muscle. Like we call it as inversing fascia. So the answer will be inversing layer of cervical fascia, which covers the sternocleidomastoid muscle and trapezius muscle. See, you can see sternocleidomastoid muscle and trapezius. So which like covers like a capsule, cervical fascia. So answer will be inversing layer of cervical fascia. The ninth one, as a result of injury, a patient cannot extend his arm to the elbow. What causes abnormal function of this following muscle? So for the extension of the like elbow, the muscle which helps for extension, we call it as trapezius brachii muscle, musculus trapezius brachii. Extension of elbow joint, which is present in the posterior surface of the arm, in this area, posterior surface of the arm, uses for extension of the elbow joint. A casualty has a fracture in the region of inner surface of the left ankle. What is the most site for fracture? That is medial malleolus. You can see inner surface of the left ankle. So there will be medial malleolus fracture. As a result of an injury of the knee joint, a patient shows a drawer sign. What is anterior posterior displacement of the tibia relative to the femur? What ligament are damaged? So drawer sign means like we put our hand behind the like popliteal fossa and we'll check like anterior posterior movement of the knee joint. So if it is going anterior and posteriorly, so there is a damage to your ligament called anterior cruciate ligament. We call it as that is the drawer sign, especially for you to check the damage or tear in the anterior cruciate ligament. So you can see in the image, anterior cruciate ligament attached to a knee. After a hand fracture, a man lost his ability to touch his little finger with a thumb on a affected hand. Examination of the palmar surface of the hand shows atrophied. So what muscle is affected? So musculus opinus pollicis, which is presented in the hypothenar region. In the hypothenar region, we have a 3 muscle. One of the muscle is opinus pollicis, which is used to opposed to the thumb. A 25-year-old woman complains of visual impairment. Examination revealed disturbed eye dilation, unresponsive to light. What muscles are functionally disturbed in this case? So in the option they gave you like 5 options. Every option there is explanation you can read. For the eye dilation and unresponsiveness to the light, the muscle name is iris sphincter muscle and ciliary muscle. Iris sphincter muscle is used to do constriction of the pupil and accommodation and for like a camera, zoom in and zoom out. So if it is damaged to this iris sphincter muscle and ciliary muscle, there will be a constriction of pupil and accommodation will be disturbed. So thanks for watching. This is all about anatomy topic 1 and topic 2, skeletal and muscular system and the surface of anatomy. We'll move on to next topics, all the topics. So thanks for watching. Thank you. You can download this material from my Blogspot, easywaytolearnmedicine.blogspot.com. Also, you can download explanate your question papers. Thank you. Thanks for watching.